Hello learners, welcome in this session on Enhancing Professional Competencies Courses or EPC Courses, which are part of our B.Ed curriculum in IGNOU. You all may be knowing that in first year, we have our two EPC courses. The first course is BESL 121, Reading and Reflecting on the Texts. And the second course is BESL 122, Application of ICT. Both the courses are of 2 credits each. In first year courses, there are 4 activities in each EPC course. So there are 2 courses, means total 8 activities. In each course, 2 activities will be completed by you during your internship period, and rest 2 activities in each course will be completed by you during the workshop 1. Please note that there is no term end examination for any EPC course. The activities which have been suggested in your practical handbook are to be completed either before the workshop, that is during internship period, or during the workshop. Dear learners, before coming to workshop 1, you have to complete 2 activities in each EPC course, that is in BESL 121 and BESL 122. As you all know, that whatever activities you will do during your internship period, reports of those activities should be duly verified by the mentors and authenticated by the head or principal of your internship school that you have completed those activities. And assessment of all the reports which you will develop during your internship period or the activities which you will complete during the workshops, assessment of the reports will be done during the workshops only. Let us talk about different courses and their activities. First course is BESL 121, Reading and Reflecting on the Texts. Let us talk about the activities which are there in the course BESL 121. There are 4 activities in this EPC course 1. Types of texts in our school curriculum, metacognition for reading. These 2 activities you have to complete during your internship before coming for workshop 1. And using different texts for developing critical thinking skills and reading across curriculum. These 2 activities you will do during your workshop 1. Let us talk about each of these activities. The first activity is type of texts in our school curriculum. It is an individual activity which you will complete during internship 1. Before attempting for this activity, you are suggested that please read unit 1 of block 1 of your course BESL 121. First, you list different characteristics of each type of text that you come across in different school textbooks. Then you identify different types of texts with 1 example each, which are commonly being used in your discipline, either from NCERT textbooks or the textbooks which are in your school. Then you can choose any 1 type of text as per your choice, and you write a paragraph on your own. You can write a poem, you can write a story, you can write a drama if you are a literature teacher. You can write some technical text if you are a science teacher. So it depends upon you what kind of text you want to develop. But the idea that what are different types of text you will collect from the books which you are using in your teaching learning at your school. So this activity will be assessed basically on the basis of characteristics of different types of texts which you have identified, the type of text you come across in the disciplines being taught by you. You have been asked to give 1 example of each type of text identified by you from either NCERT textbook or school textbook, and the text or paragraph or whatever literature you will develop on your own. So all these things should be the part of your report which will be assessed during workshop 1. The second activity in the first course is metacognition for reading. This is again an individual activity which you will complete during your internship 1. There is a MARSI scale, metacognition awareness of reading strategies inventory. The scale is given in the section 3.5 of unit 3 of your course BESL 121. So please go through that scale. Then you select a text from any subject area for reading. And when you are reading that text, please use the scale, the MARSI scale, which is suggested in your study material. You prepare a report on the analysis of the scores obtained by you. There are three subscales: GLOB subscale, PROP subscale, and SUP subscale, and overall score. You calculate the score obtained by you while reading the text and analyzing the text by using MARSI scale. Then write a paragraph explaining how use of metacognitive strategies suggested in MARSI scale helped you in becoming a better reader. You submit this report at the time of workshop. Your report should include the use of MARSI scale by you to assess your awareness and perceived use of reading strategies, use of MARSI scale for assessment purpose, and a paragraph written by you on your awareness and use of metacognitive strategies in becoming better readers. The third activity is using different texts for developing critical thinking skills. This activity is a mixed group activity, means participants from different disciplines will be the part of group. So this activity will be conducted during the workshop because it is a group activity and it is based on the unit 2 of your course BESL 121. Your workshop facilitator or resource person will identify a text which will give to you for reading and comprehension. Each one of you will read the text material given by your resource person, discuss about it in your group, and answer the questions given at the end of that text. The fourth activity is reading across curriculum. It is again a mixed group activity. So participants from different disciplines will form the group. The workshop facilitator will choose a few articles from different sources like newspapers, textbooks, magazines, which are related to some important topics of secondary classroom. Then that material will be given to you, or that article will be given to you. After reading that article, your group will identify at least two or three different disciplines where that concept or that material can be used. And after that, each group will develop one worksheet for reading across curriculum, that, and you will present the outcome of your group, and your presentation will be assessed by your resource person. The second course is VESL 122 Application of ICT. This course aims to develop basic ICT skills among you. So if you will see the activities in this course, there are again four activities. The first activity is use of TPACK framework, that is Technological Pedagogical Content Knowledge, and ICT for academic and non-academic administrative support to teachers. These two activities you will do during your internship. Then using a suitable resource from NROER and use of concept map software for classroom assessment. These two activities you will do during your workshop. Let us talk about the first activity, use of TPACK framework. This framework basically talks about the technological pedagogical content knowledge. It is an individual activity which you will complete during your internship. There is text about this in the unit 1 of your course BESL 122. So you read that text in the unit first. Then you identify any two topics from your discipline or subject which you are teaching. Then you choose and identify appropriate technology, keeping in mind your pedagogy and the content which you will teach and their intersections. Then you prepare a report by explaining that why you have selected that particular technology, how you will use that technology, how the technology will support your pedagogy. And this you will discuss about each topic, because there are two topics, so two such reports will be prepared by you. The second activity is ICT for academic and administrative support. This activity is again an individual activity which you will complete during your internship one. You can visit a few schools in your nearby area and interact with the teachers and identify ICT infrastructure available generally in these schools. Any three ways in which ICT has helped the teachers in providing academic support in their school. You can collect some documentary evidences also if possible. And three ways in which ICT helped those schools in providing administrative support. Then you prepare an individual report based on the information collected by you on the use of ICT in academic and administrative support in the schools where you visited. Next activity is using a suitable resource from NROER. As you all know, that National Repository of Open Educational Resources is being managed by NCERT. So because you are a school teacher and it is a subject specific group activity which you will complete during the workshop, so you will be divided in the groups based on your pedagogy subjects. Then workshop facilitator will make a short presentation about different features and resources available on NROER website for school teachers. Then each group will identify a topic from the discipline and will prepare a lesson plan by using different ICT resources available on NROER, and each group will present the plan. You will submit the lesson plan for assessment purpose, and you also mention in your lesson plan that what resources you have used from NROER. The next activity is use of concept map software for classroom assessment. This is again a subject specific group activity which will be completed during the workshop. Your workshop facilitator will give a presentation on the installation and use of software and web-based tools. We have also developed a small video how to download a software and how to use that software for concept mapping. So this is the YouTube link. You can use it and learn that how you can develop concept map. Each subject specific group will construct a concept map using that software or web-based tool. Then you will grade it with the help of set criteria. Then each group will submit the scoring criteria for grading the concept map, and each group will give its presentation. Now let us talk about the assessment of EPC activities. The assessment of all the reports of EPC activities will be done during the workshop in the assessment sessions for EPC activities. You will be asked to make a presentation of all the activities which you have completed in the EPC courses. Then you will submit the reports of all the activities in two separate portfolios, one for EPC course 1 and one for EPC course 2. Your resource person will grade your EPC activities. After the assessment of all the 8 activities, 4 for BESL 1 to 1 and 4 for BESL 1 to 2, cumulative grades will be awarded to each learner separately for the course BESL 1 to 1 and BESL 1 to 2. So this short description will help you to go through the activities of EPC courses. Still, if you have any confusion, you can write to us at soe@ignou.ac.in. So dear learners, keep learning, keep growing, and be a great teacher. Thank you very much.